We've all been dealing with the pandemic for so long now that I didn't think there was a story that could really shock me until I saw this headline. Anti-vaxxer who went to Corona party to become infected dies from COVID. Now, I know that you might think, well, I've heard of COVID parties before. Yeah, they're a thing where people just kind of are careless, and when there's a surge in their area, they'll go to a party to kind of stick it to the man and you know, tell everyone that they don't care about the virus. But this is a little bit different. This individual went to a party where somebody was actually infected, and they interacted with that person who was infected to deliberately get COVID. It's not just, we don't care about lockdowns, we're not concerned with COVID. This is, no, I'm actually trying to get infected. So the question is that I know you're wondering, where in the United States did this take place? Northern Florida? Southern Florida? Where? I'm not Florida phobic, by the way. I have friends from Florida, okay? Jen and Peter, back me up on this. I don't hate people from Florida, but you'd expect it to happen in Florida, right? I mean, that's what you were thinking. But it did not happen in Florida. In fact, it did not happen in the United States at all. As Chiara Gordano of Independent explains, a man has reportedly died and others are in intensive care after attending coronavirus parties in a bid to catch the disease. The 55-year-old man died in Austria last week after becoming infected with COVID-19 during one such event in the city of Bolzano in South Tyrol, northern Italy. At least three other people, including a child, are said to have been hospitalized in the Alpine region after catching the virus at similar events. Health chiefs believe the patients are anti-vaxxers who deliberately attempt to become infected so they could obtain a green pass, which is now required for work and leisure in Italy, according to local media. The only way to get a pass in the country is either through vaccination or by recovering from infection within the previous 6 months. Patrick Franzoni, co-coordinator of the anti-COVID unit in Bolzano, told Italian newspaper Il Dolmiti, "We have received more than one account from doctors of patients who admitted to having been infected on purpose. They do this to develop antibodies and to obtain the green pass without vaccination, he said. There are long-term consequences, and even young people can end up in the hospital. According to Dr. Franzoni, at least one of the partygoers is infected with the virus, and the other attendees deliberately come into close contact with them by hugging, kissing, and sharing drinks. The practice is also thought to be widespread in Austria and Germany, with some anti-vaccine parents reportedly involving their children." Jesus Christ. So, we all thought that it was crazy how Dennis Prager of PragerU, not a real university, by the way, shared that he intentionally tried to get COVID by interacting with people, getting close to them. But these folks took it a step further. They found someone who was infected with the virus and they got close with them. I don't know if they were huffing that person's farts. I don't know if they were letting them cough in their face. You know, they talk about hugging, kissing. I don't know what to say about this. Look, on one hand, I do have sympathy for that person who died because it's sad that they are no longer around to teach people about why being stupid is bad. It's sad that they don't learn a lesson from this. But at the same time, my sympathy is limited here, right? Because as an adult, there's got to be at least some level of common sense that you need in order to survive. And that person and the people at this party very clearly lack that. I mean, if I decided to jump out of an airplane without a parachute to disprove the efficacy of parachutes, I mean, when I hit the ground and I explode, that's kind of my fault. Sure, people can feel pity for me that I was stupid enough to do something like that, but actions have consequences. And as adults, we should know that. You know, I'm not going to be surprised if I stick my dick in a meat grinder and it gets shredded because I know that that is not a good idea. I'm not going to do that to disprove how dangerous meat grinders are. There's just a baseline level of common sense that you have to have in order to survive. And these people, they clearly don't have that. And again, I'm sympathetic because I would like for them to have recovered after doing something so stupid and educate others about why these COVID parties are a thing, but they're gone. They're dead because they were fucking stupid. And that's sad. It's sad. I don't want anyone to die. But I mean, at some point, people, we have to stop being so fucking stupid. Now, I wanted to see how prevalent this phenomenon was here in the United States, and I found a couple of stories here. So a 30-year-old Texas man died after reportedly attending a COVID party, and he told his nurse that he thought it was a hoax. Although the details here aren't necessarily confirmed, I don't know that this is a COVID party in the sense that they know someone there is infected. Again, in the United States, the COVID parties that we've heard about have basically been a bunch of people gathering, knowing that that's unsafe. But I don't know that there's been a COVID party where somebody has actually been positive for COVID and was knowingly spreading it to other people. On top of that, there are reports that college students were attending COVID parties in Southern Washington in May, but it didn't necessarily, again, involve anyone who was actually there infected, knowingly spreading the illness to others. So the extent to which this is occurring in the United States honestly seems pretty rare. I honestly am shocked by that because when I heard COVID parties was a thing, I thought, okay, this is definitely happening all the time, at least biweekly in many counties in Florida, probably Texas, Mississippi, Alabama, but not necessarily. I mean, sure, we've seen COVID parties in the United States, but not where there's someone who's there who's actually infected, because I think that at that point, even these people who claim they don't care about COVID and they're not worried, I mean, that's pretty stupid. I mean, regardless of how little you fear COVID-19, even if you know that a cold isn't going to kill you, who would knowingly make themselves sick with a cold? I mean, it just, you don't feel good, right? So, yeah, I mean, it's, these people are trying to win a Darwin Award, and this is widespread in Germany and Australia. That's genuinely shocking to me. But rather than winning a Darwin Award, these people are winning Herman Cain Awards, which is the idiot cousin to the Darwin Awards, which I'm told based on the Herman Cain Awards subreddit, which is very depressing to read, by the way. But I mean, I don't know what else to say about this story. It's truly one of the dumbest stories with respect to COVID. And when I thought that nothing would surprise me, this actually does surprise me a little bit. So, I mean, the moral of the story is play stupid games, win stupid prizes.